Hare Krishna. Envy targets the envied but torments the envious. Envy is the inner weakness which makes us miserable about others' success and which makes us delight in others' failures, which makes us plot to bring others down and to think that therein lies our joy. The problem with envy is that envious people often try to pull others down. Envy targets the envied. Anybody who has beauty or wealth or intelligence or power or prestige or any kind of attractive feature, envy targets such people. And when envy is present in someone, these people always target those others whom they are envying. So for example, Duryodhan in the Mahabharata was always envious of the Pandavas, of Yudhishthir, of Bhim, of Arjun, everyone. He envied Yudhishthir because Yudhishthir was the monarch. He envied Bhim because he was so strong. He envied Arjun because Arjun had won the hands of Draupadi where Duryodhan couldn't win it. So in this way he was envious and he did many plots against the Pandavas because of his envy. But actually, he himself was constantly miserable. Envy torments the envious. Why? Because no matter how much someone achieves, still that person stays dissatisfied because of envy. So Duryodhan, even when he had sent the Pandavas to the forest after exiling them and dispossessing them of everything, still he was dissatisfied. He could not gain contentment in his attainment. Instead, he wanted to display his prosperity and delight in seeing the Pandavas' poverty. And in that process, when he went to the forest, he made a fool out of himself and humiliated himself. So because of envy, we may target others and may cause some misery to them. But because of envy, that we stay constantly dissatisfied because our definition of success doesn't depend on where we are or what we are doing. It depends on where others are and what they are doing. And how others are is not in our control. Although we may try to put them in misery, we can't succeed in that. And so because envy makes us so other-centered, it actually torments us. Envy sentences the envious to perpetual torment of dissatisfaction. That's why it is important for each one of us to free ourselves from envy. Krishna cautions about this in 16.18 when he says that ahankaram balam darpam kamam krodham cha samshritaha mamatma paradeheshu pradvishanto abhyasoyakaha. That the demoniac people are envious of others and they are envious ultimately of Krishna. And such people, as the next verses say, they suffer endlessly till they can become free from envy. So by knowing that envy hurts us much more than it hurts others, we can resolve to free ourselves from envy. And if we deepen our spirituality, connect ourselves with Krishna and relish His love for us, relish the satisfaction that comes by loving absorption in Him, then we will realize that we don't need envy. That envy can't provide us anything anywhere near what Krishna can provide us. And thus, by embracing Krishna's lotus feet, we can push envy out of our hearts. Thank you. Hare Krishna.